What is Cafe Mocha? Cafe Mocha is experts, celebrities.
What's up? This is Belle Biv DeVoe.
Yo, it's Julie Idris Elba.
This is Fantasia.
This is Invo.
This is India RE.
Hey, what's up? This is Brandy.
Music and features from a woman's perspective. Intriguing conversation. Espresso. The Mocha Mix. So much more. All from a woman's perspective.
What flavor are you, baby?
This is Cafe Mocha.
This week we've got R&B songstress Leela James, fresh from her appearance on Unsung. We'll talk about pandemic life, the new album, and why she almost turned down Unsung. Plus, did you hear who we're honoring for the Salute Them Awards next month? Earth, Wind, and Fire, Patrice Russian, Sly Stone, the list goes on. It's streaming live on June 6th, 7 p.m. at SaluteThemAwards.com or catch it on the Black News Channel at 10 p.m. Cafe Mocha begins now. This is Cafe Mocha, home of the ladies, you know? This is what we do right here. Leela James is on the line, R&B singer. She was just in TV One's Uncensored. She's got a new single called Complicated. Mm-hmm. Welcome, Leela. Welcome back to Cafe Mocha. How are you?
I'm good, thank y'all. Thank y'all for having me, too. Yes. How are you guys?
You. We're good.
Well, I mean, let me tell you, ladies, Leela's new single, Complicated, she debuted the video on The Real. When I tell you hot, hot.
Come up with
the concept for the single, Leela?
You know what? It wasn't complicated, just life, just looking at folks, and sometimes they just do stupid stuff, and you're like, you just didn't even have to do that. Like, you didn't even have to do that like that. And it's it's just easy. You just, for me, just to pull from experience, just life, just people, this pandemic, everything.
Mm-hmm. You know, watching the video, it just reminded me of how powerful you really are. And being an artist for so long and having to reinvent yourself within this new generation of just being open and honest with your lyrics. I mean, has that changed with your soulful style?
I think so. I think, you know, we're constantly growing and evolving. I know I'm not even the same person I was, you know, last year, let alone 10 years or so ago. So, I'm definitely going to be saying and moving a little differently. You know, the older I get, I feel extra grown. I've been grown, but I feel extra grown now. So, you know what I mean? It's you definitely settle into I wish that somebody would type thing. Like, it just, yeah, as you continue to grow and get older, everything else around you, I think, at least it should move with you. And that means even how you approach things and your mindset and maybe things you would say, you may not say, or things you might have said back in, you know, the day you're not going to say, because certain things ain't even always worth the energy. Then some things you do, like, need to let them know.
I heard that. It's Cafe Mocha on the line. R&B singer. We love her. Leela James. Her new single is called Complicated. Also, she was just on TV One's Uncensored. How was that process, Leela? You know, doing the whole Uncensored, was it revealing? Did you enjoy it? You didn't like it?
No, it initially, it was actually, I think, Unsung. And it was, initially, it was, at first I was apprehensive because I tend to be pretty private and I didn't know, like, how they were gonna, you know, I didn't want my story to be told with a spin. If you were gonna talk about it, it was like, you don't, you know, tell it the way it's supposed to be told. So initially I was a little apprehensive. Then I was like, you know what, again, I'm grown. It is what it is. Like, everybody got a life, everybody done lived. So I felt like I need to tell a little bit because I don't really speak much. So I said, I'll speak. And as long as y'all don't be trying to do nothing stupid with editing, we would do it.
Were you happy with your Unsung?
I was. I really was, actually. I was pleased. But I didn't like some of the photos they used. I was like, golly, y'all picked the ugliest pictures ever, but it's all good. That's the truth, too. Like, I was like, well, they couldn't. They getting all the real. I was like, it's a lie when folk act like they just was always pretty. I was like, nah, I was ugly as hell.
You're so young, and to have done an Unsung, I'm just curious to, do you feel you've reached your high point, or are you still pushing your way through?
Oh, definitely still pushing that. You know, we had a joke throughout the filming, because that was the other thing. I was like, why are y'all calling me to do an Unsung? I was like, I'm still singing. Like, what are you talking about? I'm putting out music. Like, nah, like, it's too soon. And they were like, well, we're changing the direction of how we do the show. It's more about, you know, introducing new audiences to who you are as an artist and showcasing you as an entertainer, as an artist, and telling your story, not as if it's the end of your story, but just so people know who you are. Because there's so many artists like myself that don't always get all the commercial exposure that people don't know. So they're like, this is a new format and new way of like kind of showcasing that. And I was like, okay, cool. Long as y'all know I'm still singing.
Okay.
I'm good.
Definitely. But you know, what really hit the charts for you were actually two songs. One was Say That with my man, Anthony Hamilton. And, you know, what was that process like working with Anthony?
Oh, it was real cool. We have like toured together and been doing shows over the years. And so we always spoke about, you know, working together and recording, and scheduling sometimes doesn't always permit that. And then so one time, you know, it was just like, let's just go on and get this done. I sent him the record and he actually sent it back to me with his vocals. I was like, are you kidding me? We actually recorded a song together. We did it this time. And we ended up, you know, putting it out. It was one of the first singles off of that project. And I was very excited because it felt like, dang, after all these years, we finally recorded. Because people will always be like, you're like a female Anthony Hamilton. And I'm like, no, nah, I'm a female. What are you talking about? Like,
I love you. You are so funny.
So cute. And talk about your process for Fall For You. Like, that was another chart topper as well.
Yeah, that process was really with Rex Rideout, my producer as well. We were working one day in the studio and he was like, I want to try something different. And I just really want you to get on the mic and sing. I'm just going to play the piano and you just sing. And I was like, what? You know, he was like, yep, let's just do it. Just no beats, nothing right now. This is all voice and piano. And I was like, okay. And so that's what came out. And now we got this song.
That's a great one. Leela,
Leela, I wanted you to talk about this new album. So what can we expect from this new album? Are you writing on it? Do you have any features? Give us the inside.
Yeah. I definitely wrote on the album. I write all, you know, all my albums. I did a collaboration with some people, and I can't say just yet because the ink is still wet on the paperwork on them contracts.
I heard that.
But yes, I feel really good about it. I was telling my mother, I was like, I got in my feelings a lot with this album, and I think it had a lot to do with this past year that I just couldn't avoid. So yeah, I'm in my feelings on a lot of different directions.
You said earlier in the interview that you aren't even the same as you were the year before last. So what has happened for you this past year? I mean, you know, we've all been hit by the pandemic, but what's happened to you specifically this year that you feel has changed you so much?
I mean, it's several things. I think definitely, of course, the pandemic just pushed everything over the top, but I was already going through some things personally that was starting to shift me from being a mother of one to being a mother of two, getting married, then turning around and also getting divorced, and then living life and trying to juggle and balance it all. And you know, working in the industry as a Black woman, then as a woman that doesn't always, you know, fit the format of what this industry tries to force you to do. And so much. And then my filter ain't always the best. I see stuff I don't like. I might say, I tell you I don't like it. And, you know, then I'm still trying to be somebody's mama and I'm a daughter and I'm an auntie. Like, it's a lot. I got bills to pay like the next person. We got to eat. We in the pandemic. Ain't no work done stop. It was a lot. So, yeah.
You know what I wanted to ask, Leela? I follow you a lot on social media, and I always wondered with R&B up and coming artists, is it hard for those in the industry to work with the new artists in R&B and those that you feel, is the relationship between women and R&B difficult to obtain?
Well, not for me, but I see how it can be for some, because some people are into themselves and they get caught up into the idea of what this thing is and they buy the hype of it. Mm-hmm. I love everybody. I got love for everybody. I support, and especially my sisters, you know, because we all in this thing together. So I don't buy into the, you know, oh, she doing this, so I got to one up her, or this one, and everybody's in competition. Like, that's foolishness. Like, your competition is yourself.
That's
the,
right.
The person that's looking in the mirror. So I'm all about, if we can kind of empower each other or support, like, what is it going to hurt you to post my damn song? Like, it ain't taking nothing away from your followers. They just, like, going to follow me too. Like, what does that mm-hmm. hurt? Like, I never get how people don't want to share their platforms and or just share whatever, because how do we help one another if we don't literally help each other?
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's not hard for me, but I do see how some people make it hard. They make things complicated. And yeah. That's why we kind of are in also the predicament that we tend to be in.
You know, that's the way we have been sort of raised, is that like there ain't enough food for all of us. There ain't enough beds for all of us. There ain't enough. So we always feel like whenever we get a little bit of something, we feel like we got to protect it with whatever. And I understand, and there's enough room. There's enough food. There's
right.
enough, there's enough yep. whatever for all of us to eat.
Yep.
Yeah. It's a deep-seated mentality that goes back to, you know, times of enslavement, if you ask me. And we just got to break those cycles and those strongholds and understand, like you said, it's enough. It literally really is. It's more than enough.
That's right.
You know, it's more than enough. And, you know, if we can accept that and buy into that aspect of things versus, oh, no, I got to have this for myself. Oh, I can't let this person get on, because if I get on, they get it. And then they, like, that's crazy to me. Like, dude, like, help somebody. Because you, when you bless somebody else, you really blessing yourself.
All day long.
So if you want that blessing, bless somebody else. God don't give you stuff for you to just sit on it. That's why he take it away when you don't get it.
It is.
Leela, what advice would you give to young women out there, you know, the young mothers, they're trying to, you know, reach their goals? Do you have any advice for them as they're trying to reach their goals?
Well, I always just tell my daughters, and I was told, believe in yourself and be secure in who you are, and don't look to your left or right. Just look ahead and focus. I ran track and I was always told focus, because if you look into the left and the right of you, that's going to slow you down and you're going to get off focus. So stay focused, stay on to yourself. Don't worry about the next one and what they're doing and what they're not doing. Focus on yourself, be secure in yourself, and everything else will start coming to you the way it needs to come.
Definitely. Leela, when a new album comes out, you got to come back and talk to us about it.
Oh, man, I sure would. I'd love to.
All right. Go ahead.
I was going to say, yeah, give us your Instagram so people can follow your journey. I just love following you. I just love your soulfulness on your Instagram page. And, you know, I want people to follow your journey. Make sure they tune in.
Oh, thank you. Yes, I'm on Instagram, Leela James Official. That's where you can follow me there. Twitter is Leela James Official. Just did the TikTok thing, started that account. That's funny, whatever. It's Leela James, too. I got like 3 followers or something.
So you up there TikToking? Are you TikToking?
Yeah, man. I be TikToking trying.
Leela James, thanks for stopping through Cafe Mocha. Y'all, listen to her new single, Pick It Up.
Go
it's
pick
called
it up.
Complicated.
Complicated.
Thank you.
Y'all so much. Thank you. Love you guys, man. Stay safe and be blessed.
I love you, Queen.
You too, Leela. All
right.
Love you. Bye-bye.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
All right, y'all.
Hey, this is Claude Kelly from We Sound Crazy with your Black Music Month Spotlight. Victoria Monet is an American singer and songwriter. As an artist, Monet released the second installment of her Jaguar trilogy, titled Jaguar 2. The album won Best R&B Album and Best Engineered Album, Non-Classical, at the 66th Grammy Awards and featured hit singles such as Smoke.
So I know I want the generation that where that music was their prime to appreciate it, but also my generation to find some of the lyrics fun and use them as captions. So I want to have that juxtaposition.
Party Girls and the RAA certified platinum track, On My Mama.
Hey, it's Angelique here. Walt Disney World Resort is bringing you The Culture with music, art, and food. Imagine savoring Princess and the Frog's decadent bread pudding and Barry Bonet's at Disney's Port Orleans Resort. Take in Disney's Animal Kingdom Park's Circle of Life Festival, celebrating the Lion King and more. Walt Disney World Resort is a place where you can come and celebrate with your family, and you can do it soulfully. Bring yourself to Walt Disney World Resort and celebrate The Culture.
This is Cafe Mocha. It's time for another Salute Them Awards, June 6th. And this is from a place that is brand spanking new.
Yes.
The National Museum of African American Music in Nashville. We've been talking about it for months. I haven't been, but
it is beautiful.
It is beautiful.
Oh, you're going to fall in love. You're going to fall in love. It is so huge. They're honoring so many people.
I know we are. I mean, we got a lot of people on this list. We're gonna go through it real quick. Sly Stone, June Ambrose, Jamal Joseph, Earth, Wind, and Fire, Billy Woodruff, Dr. Bobby Jones, Therese Russian, Ludacris, and Darlene Love is sponsored by Toyota and AARP. I am so excited. You know, Yo-Yo is gonna be down there. Angelique gonna do them voiceovers. I'm gonna be down there along with Saint, and it's the Salute Them Awards on June the 6th in honor of Black Music Month.
Yes,
I'm excited.
Got to everybody, we ain't seen Sly Stone since '75, so I'm like excited. Like
to say Patrice Russian's name just gives me chills.
I love her.
And this is a nice mix of people. When we talk about Black music and the history of Black music, it's always been, you know, we're just everywhere. It doesn't matter whether it's soul, whether it's jazz, whether it's rap, the oldies, you know, Darlene Love, you know, Rock and Roll Hall of Famer. It just shows this is a nice mix of people. You know, really is.
Yeah.
June 6th. And of course, you can stream it live at saluteher.com. And I can't wait.
I can't wait either. Yo, I'll see you down there.
I'll see you down there. Go to saluteher.com. I guess it's all in my
head until you let my... Here's your dose of espresso. Strong, hot news now.
This is the espresso. People outside of Atlanta may have missed this announcement, but fearless Black mayor Keisha Lance Bottoms announced that she's not running for a second term.
So my love for this city was a love planted in my heart long before I was formed in my mother's womb. It is abundantly clear to me today that it is time to pass the baton on to someone else.
Everyone's curious about what's next for her. While we're in Georgia, this week the three men who hunted down Ahmaud Arbery and killed him pleaded not guilty in court. In good news, though, Georgia threw out an old law that protected the men that did it.
This bill makes Georgia the first state in the country to appeal its citizens' arrest statute. Ahmaud was the victim of a vigilante style of violence that has no place in our country or in our state.
And Maya Angelou is on a quarter.
The coins will enter circulation starting in January as part of the American Women Quarters program. In all, 20 women will be featured on quarters.
I want one. I'm Angelique. That's the espresso.
Yo, DJ.
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 mix starts now with DJ Farrah Floss.
This lady got it going on.
Here we go.
Sitting here flossing, 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 flossing.
Please hold. Your call will now be directed to Farrah Flossett.
A million.
I did it again.
A million.
What's up, right?
A million.
I know.
A million.
I know what y'all keep asking yourself.
A million.
Is it gonna ever fall off?
A million.
No.
A million.
A lot of speculation on the monies I've made, honeys I've slayed. How is he for real? Is that nigga really paid? Hustlers I've met or dealt with direct. Is it true he stayed a beef and slept with a tech? What's the position you hold? Can you really match a triple platinum artist buck by buck, but only a single going gold? Rockefeller should let go, and you're left out in the cold. Is it back to charge your motherfuckers 11 for a O? For the millionth time, asking me questions like Wendy Williams harassing me. They get upset when I catch feelings. Can I get a minute to breathe? And then that minute you leave, while I'm looking at my roll ice spinning on my sleeve. Ugh, nice watch. Do you really have a spot? Like you said in front of foe, and if so, what block? What you doing in LA with Filipinos and essays, Latinos and Chevys down by Pico with Federico? I answer all y'all questions, but then y'all got to go. Now the question I ask you is, how bad you wanna know? Black. Rockefeller. Rockefeller, yo. Rockefeller, jigga. How we do? 98.
You're in the Mocha Mix.
Mocha Mix
on Cafe Mocha.
Beauty of it all when the sun comes shining.
make those rainbows in my mind when I think of you sometime, and I want to spend some time with you. Just the two of us, we can make it if we try.
Mike Tyson, the street airs with no socks. The Hugh Hefner for the game, yeah, and it won't stop. Till I meet the Lord Pro for the hood, it's all good. The Spielberg when I spill words to track. I'm a sick dude, you can't feel worse than that. For you slow-minded dudes, I reverse it back. I got a sick flow, see, ain't no nursing that. But mommy, if you rock my world, I get you the baby bucket. You can be my baby ride girl. White Nike Airs, we call them wifey Airs. Size 4 or 5, how cute is your size? That new cute bubble, give you horses to drive. I paint that picture, cause ain't no like the one you get from Mike Holler.
I don't think they're ready for this one.
My life would never be the same. Cause girl, you came and changed the way I walk, the way I talk. I cannot explain the things I feel for you. Girl, you know it's true. Stay with me, I feel my dreams, and I'll be all you need.
Feel so right,
girl.
Ladies of Cafe Mocha are headed to the brand new National Museum of African American Music in Nashville for the Salute Them Awards. Unfortunately, it's going to be virtual, but the list of honorees is show-stopping, like Earth, Wind & Fire and Ludacris. Plus, you'll be able to catch it on TV for the first time ever. The date is Sunday, June 6th at 10 p.m. on BNC, the Black News Channel. Go to SaluteThemAwards.com for more details. That's it for us this week. If you need us, you know where to find us on all platforms at Cafe Mocha Radio.
Cafe Mocha is a production of Miles Ahead Broadcasting in partnership with Compass Media. Executive producer Sheila Eldridge. For comments, booking, or more information, visit CafeMochaRadio.com.
Hi, this is Chuck Harmony from We Sound Crazy with your Black Music Month Spotlight. Missy Elliott is a pioneering American songwriter, rapper, singer, and producer. She emerged in the 1990s as part of the R&B girl group SZA and gained widespread recognition for her innovative approach to performance and music production.
Me, I'm super fly, super duper fly, super duper fly. Me, I'm super fly, super duper fly.
In 2020, Billboard ranked her at number 5 on their list of the 100 greatest music video artists of all time. And in 2023, Elliott became the first female rapper inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Being the first to be inducted in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame means so much to me because I never thought that in a million years, like that's probably the top tier of making it as an artist.
Hey, it's Angelique here. Walt Disney World Resort is bringing you The Culture. With music, art, and food, imagine savoring Princess and the Frog's decadent bread pudding and Berry Bonet's at Disney's Port Orleans Resort. Take in Disney's Animal Kingdom Park's Circle of Life Festival, celebrating the Lion King and more. Walt Disney World Resort is a place where you can come and celebrate with your family, and you can do it soulfully. Bring yourself to Walt Disney World Resort and celebrate the culture.